Hello, you're watching The Wire. Yesterday in Rajya Sabha, the Transgender Persons Protection of Rights Bill was passed. It was tabled by the Social Justice and Empowerment Minister, Teherchand Gehlot, amid protests from the trans community in the country. With me in the studios is Ray, a law student and a member of the AUD Queer Collective, and Saransh, a trans man from Delhi. Welcome to the discussion, both of you. To give a brief background to our viewers, in 2014, in the Nalsar versus Union of India judgment, it was recognized that trans community have a right to self-determination, which means that they have the right to choose their gender identity. Subsequently, in 2014, in a private member's bill that was tabled in the Lok Sabha by Tiruchi Siva of the DMK, the bill too said that the trans community has a right to self-determination. It had certain provisions to which the trans community agreed to. But despite the judgment and the bill, by not taking these two into consideration, the government passed another bill of its own, which is the Transgender Persons Protection of Rights Bill. And amid a lot of protests from the community, since 2 years, since the first time it was spoken about in 2016. So my first question to you, Ray, is that this is the revised version of the bill. Mm-hmm. The first bill that was tabled had provisions which said that begging will be criminalized, sex work will be criminalized, and the definition of a transgender person that was given was not adequate. Now, in the revised version, since sex work and begging forms a chief sort of source of income for the community, they have decriminalized it, and they've also changed the definition. Is the community still happy with the definition that they've given to a transgender person in the bill?
No, unfortunately, the definition, although it's an improved version, that came after a lot of protests from the trans community. Unfortunately, the definition still conflates intersex persons with transgender persons. Intersex persons are not as same as transgender persons. They may identify as transgender persons, but what the bill does is, under the definition of transgender persons, it puts intersex persons also. Thereby, what it does is it's taking away their choice to identify as cisgender persons, as male or female, and are transgender persons. Because what happens is, the moment you're putting them in there, you are essentially taking away their agency to self-identify, which is violative of Nalsar judgment.
All right. My second question is that this bill has a provision of a district screening committee, which will give the trans person will be required to produce a gender certificate and a screening by a district magistrate. Now, what will this entail, if you can briefly describe to our viewers, what will this entail? What is a gender certificate that you're required to provide?
Basically, my legal documents, even now, they say that I am a male. So, I am a woman, a trans woman. So, if I were to change the legal documents to a woman, the bill, if it's passed, requires me to go to the district magistrate, apply. And if I were to do it before I get the surgery done, I will be only given certificate as a transgender person. I will not be given certificate as a woman. Once I get the surgery done, I'll have to get the certificate of the surgeon, the chief medical officer of the institution. Then I'll have to reapply to the district magistrate. And the bill, quote unquote, uses the word satisfied. And basically, I'll have to satisfy the district magistrate that I am a woman. I don't know what that means, because the Nalsar judgment talks about self-identification, and hence this bill is in violation of Nalsar judgment. It is in violation of the rights given, fundamental rights given under the Constitution, because the Constitution talks about Article 21, right to live life with dignity. The bill essentially denies us dignity by saying that we'll have to go to a third person, a district magistrate, to get ourselves certified, and we'll have to satisfy that person to say that we are a man or a woman. It sets up a two-step process. First, you will be identified only as a transgender person without surgery. Then, if you get the surgery done, provided you satisfy the DM and the chief medical officer, you'll get your certificate as a man or a woman.
So there are two problems with this. One is that it's conforming the trans community into binaries.
Yes.
And second, it's making surgery mandatory.
Yes.
Right. So I want to understand from you, Saransh, that how well is our country equipped with medical practitioners to carry out surgeries in the first place?
Firstly, if we go to a doctor and say that we want to get the sex change surgery done, they say that why do you want to get it done firstly? You can live as it is. सेकेंडली वो हमारी तरफ वो नहीं होते हैं कि मतलब आंसरेबल नहीं होते हैं कि हम कोई कुछ भी सर्जरी कर सकते हैं बिकॉज हम उनके अधीन होते हैं कि आप सर्जरी करेंगे तब हम आगे जाके अपना अप्लाई कर सकते हैं तो वो हमारे वो अपने आप को समझते हैं कि हम हैं जो इनको मेल या फीमेल प्रूफ करने के लिए हेल्पफुल करेंगे जबकि एक जो बच्चा होता है जो बचपन से पैदा होता है वो अपने आप को अगर जैसे मैं फीमेल पैदा हुआ था लेकिन मैं सेकेंड क्लास से अपने आप को मेल मानता हूँ तो ये सर्जरी कोई भी सर्जरी मेरे को एज अ मेल नहीं बना सकती है जबकि मेरे ये सिर्फ माइंड की बात है कोई डॉक्टर कोई जादू की छड़ी नहीं है कि वो अपनी जादू की छड़ी घुमाएंगे और कोई मेल बन गया या जादू की छड़ी घुमाएंगे कोई फीमेल बन गया तो और ऊपर से इतनी सारी मतलब कि अभी तक प्रैक्टिस भी नहीं है अगर हम किसी डॉक्टर पर जाते हैं वो हमें ऐसा समझते हैं कि मतलब सिर्फ प्रैक्टिस के लिए कि मतलब कि हम इन पर सर्जरी करेंगे उसके बाद हमारे पास क्लाइंट्स आएंगे और उसके बाद हम अपना हाथ साफ करेंगे जबकि अगर मेरे कई लोग हैं उनकी सर्जरी बिल्कुल अच्छी नहीं हुई है उनकी लाइफ बर्बाद कर दी गई है और वो बहुत ज़्यादा प्रॉब्लम में है लेकिन डॉक्टर आंसरेबल ही नहीं है इस चीज़ के लिए
तो फॉर एग्जांपल अगर ये जो ये बोल रहे हैं कि हमें जेंडर सर्टिफिकेट अगर नहीं प्रोवाइड कर पाए या नहीं किसी ने कर पाया या नहीं इतनी अवेयरनेस तो फिर तो क्या आपके डॉक्यूमेंट्स नहीं बन पाएंगे क्या आपके पासपोर्ट्स नहीं बन पाएंगे क्या आप ट्रैवल नहीं कर सकते ऐसा
उसमें डॉक्यूमेंट्स नहीं बन पाएंगे अभी तो सरकार ये कह रही है कि आप हमारे पास आइए हम आपको ट्रांसजेंडर बोलेंगे कि हाँ आप ट्रांसजेंडर हो जबकि अकॉर्डिंग टू मी मैं तो एक मेल हूँ मैं तो सरकार को ये बोल रहा हूँ कि मैं मेल हूँ और मैं मेरे को एक मेल का सर्टिफिकेट दे दीजिए वो कह रहे हैं नहीं वो कह रहे हैं उनका कहना ये है कि पहले हम आपको ट्रांसजेंडर घोषित करेंगे जबकि अपने पेरेंट्स को बताना कि हम ट्रांसजेंडर हैं वो बहुत बड़ी बात होती है एक एज अ फीमेल मैंने मतलब कि अपने घर में बोलना कि मैं एक मेल हूँ ये बहुत मेरे लिए प्रॉब्लम की बात रही थी और अब ये बोलना कि मैं एक ट्रांसजेंडर हूँ सरकार कह रही है कि आप ट्रांसजेंडर हो आप जाइए सर्जरी कराइए पहले तो वो बोलेंगे पेरेंट्स बोलेंगे सर्जरी किस लिए क्या आपको खुद को सेटिस्फाइड नहीं है अपनी बॉडी से सर्जरी किस लिए करवाएंगे उसके बाद सरकार हमें सेटिस्फाई अगर होगी वो तो हमको मेल या फीमेल सर्टिफिकेट देंगे उसके बाद सारे डॉक्यूमेंट्स चेंज होंगे उसके बाद ही कोई अपना लाइफ जी पाएगा जबकि सर्जरी के लिए इतने पैसे ही नहीं होते हैं ट्रांसजेंडर के पास एक अगर कोई जो बच्चा पहले जॉब ही नहीं कर पाएगा जब तक उसको अपने सर्टिफिकेट चेंज नहीं होंगे क्योंकि एज अ फीमेल जॉब करना तो मेरे लिए बहुत मुश्किल बात होगी और किसी और जैसे मेल टू फीमेल है उनको एज अ मेल जॉब करना बहुत मुश्किल की बात होगी तो जब तक जॉब ही नहीं करेंगे तब तक पैसे ही नहीं होंगे तो सर्जरी की बात कहाँ से आएगी उसके बाद सर्टिफिकेट की बात कहाँ से आ गई और ये बहुत ऊपर से कह रहे हैं कि पेरेंट्स की परमिशन चाहिए पेरेंट जबकि इसमें पेरेंट्स तो कभी परमिशन देंगे ही नहीं वो तो ये चाहते हैं कि उनको तो लगता है कि बच्चा जो बोल रहा है वो सही नहीं है उनके हिसाब
से पेरेंट्स की परमिशन एग्जैक्टली क्या है सो द सर्टिफिकेट विल बी रिक्वायर्ड टू साइन बाय द पेरेंट ऑफ द चाइल्ड ऑफ द ट्रांस चाइल्ड
Yes, if it's a child, the parents have to sign. On the one hand, the bill says ki if there is any problem with your family, the court will decide where a trans child will live, probably in a rehabilitation center, as the bill mentions. And on the other hand, while they are trying to say that there is family abuse by family, on the other hand, they are failing to recognize the fact that the same family will deny consent to the surgery. Then till 18 years of age, the person, the trans child will have to go through a lot. And even after 18, I am 24. I do not have the money to go through this surgery. And every trans person need not go through surgery. This bill makes us mandatory. And when you are saying transgender persons, there is a huge amount of diversity in it. There are trans women, there are trans men, there are trans non-binary persons, there are traditional identities like Hijra, Kinnars, Arvani, there are so many, Jogappas, there are so many. And everyone need not fall into your dhancha of man or woman to identify as man or woman.
So these rehabilitation centers which they are saying, so these are going to be separate from the gharanas and the community that, why is that so?
See, the bill does not at any place, while the bill says in the definition that it recognizes hijras and jogappas and stuff, the problem is it does not recognize the communities. please understand that the word ejda, kinnar, koti, all these words are loaded words which come from a community. It doesn't come from just one individual. There are socio-cultural, transgender, gender non-conforming, intersex groups in this country. This bill does not recognize their structures. It takes away our right to reside and move, which is a fundamental right in this country, and says that we can't go and live with them. If we are under 18, we can't go and live with them. We'll have to be put in a rehabilitation center. We all know what is the state of existing rehabilitation centers in this country. So, and the state should not be deciding through a legislation where trans children should be living. We have our friends, we have other places where we can go live.
Okay, so the other issue that you took up in the press conference also earlier this today was the fact that the sexual offences, the punishment for sexual offences is 2 years, 6 months to 2 years.
Yes.
For all kinds of sexual offences.
Yes.
Which is what, if you can detail out for me a bit?
See, the bill mentioned kar raha hai ki if you are economic, emotional, sexual, sare shoshan, sare abuse ke liye, there will be 6 months to 2 years. Now, when the debate happened in Rajya Sabha, Thavar Chand Gehlot, the social justice minister and the leader of the house, rose up and said that they consulted with other MPs and that sexual abuse is different from rape provisions in the Indian Penal Code. But again, social justice minister is forgetting that Indian Penal Code in section 8 and 10 mentions sex and gender. It very clearly has man and woman. So what happens if a transgender person, trans woman, trans man do not necessarily fall into your definition of man or woman? If you were to say that we are man or woman according to the bill only after surgery, then the Indian Penal Code will not protect us before surgery. We are not exactly man or woman according to this bill before surgery. Then where is our protection? Legally, we will change our gender to say transgender person. Where is transgender person in the Indian Penal Code? Let them show that. In IPC 376, in sexual harassment provisions 354 and all, where are transgender persons? We are not there. Even in there was a case, in fact, in University of Delhi that happened and went to Delhi High Court. Delhi High Court only could use it to 354 ko interpret kiya. तभी क्योंकि उसमें तीन provisions में victim का gender नहीं डाला है. तो एक provision में, third provision में woman डाला है, तो वो हमारे लिए applicable नहीं है करके judge ने बता दिया. तो reality of the country is this.
And in the present scenario, any kind of abuse that you may face, discrimination, molestation, groping, what do you do?
We stay silent. See, even under this bill, it's a 6 months to 2 years, as a law student I know, is a bailable offence. अगर आप bailable offence को समझना चाहो, ये समझिए कि bail में दो stage है. या तो आप police station में ही bail मिल जाएगा, या तो judge के पास आप arrest होने के बाद bail मिलेगा. ये 6 महीने से 2 साल में तो clearly police station में ही we get the bail, the abuser or the accused will get the bail. Then why will a victim of violence, sexual violence or emotional violence, why will any transgender person come and complain? In the first place, because we all know court system in this country is a long drawn process. The while it is for women 7 years and not a bailable offence, why is it a bailable offence for us? Why are you making it that way? Essentially you are saying we are not equal. Ye women yahan pe hain, those who are not transgender persons. Trans women, transgender persons, ab yahan pe hain.
So now what does the community want to do? Abhi community kya, are they saying that the president should not sign the bill? Kya hai? What is the next step that you want to?
President should not sign the bill at all. And secondly, matlab, at least they should reach to transgender community. Abhi to they think that transgender is hijras, basically. There is no knowledge of transgender persons. मतलब सो अभी तो उन्होंने बल्कि उनसे भी जाके पूछा नहीं है देखा जाए तो. अगर आपको पता ही नहीं होगा कि कौन क्या है, आप उसकी तरफ से क्या, और प्रोटेक्शन किस चीज़ की आप प्रोटेक्शन दे रहे हैं हमें? प्रोटेक्शन अगर ये यूज़ कर रहे हैं वर्ड, तो किस चीज़ की प्रोटेक्शन दे रहे हैं? सिर्फ हमें एक सर्टिफिकेट देने के लिए कि हाँ आप ट्रांसजेंडर हो, उसके बाद क्या? उसके बाद अगर आपको मेल बनना ठीक है, आप मेल हो या फीमेल हो, उसके बाद क्या मतलब आप क्या देना चाहते हैं? फिर आप फिर ये भी बोलते हैं कि कई लोग इसका मिसयूज़ करेंगे, लेकिन मिसयूज़ करके उनको फ़ायदा क्या होगा? ऑलरेडी जैसे बचपन से, पहली बात तो स्कूल में जब ड्रेस होता है वहीं से उसका अत्याचार शुरू हो जाता है, क्योंकि एज अ फीमेल ड्रेस करके जाना और किसी को क्या बताना, कोई साइकाइट्रिस्ट नहीं है, कोई बच्चे के साथ बच्चों के साथ बात करने के लिए कुछ नहीं है, वो अपने आप को बता ही नहीं सकते हैं। और जब ये आ गया है कि आपको ट्रांसजेंडर प्रूफ करना पड़ेगा, तो अब तो बच्चे बिल्कुल भी अपने पेरेंट्स से बात नहीं करेंगे। और कई UPSC एस्पायरेंट्स भी हैं हमारे में, ऐसा नहीं, इनको लगता है कि सारा मतलब जो ट्रांसजेंडर उनमें कोई दिमाग नहीं है, कुछ नहीं है, जबकि UPSC एस्पायरेंट्स हैं, डॉक्टर्स हैं, काफ़ी सारे लोग हैं जो ट्रांसजेंडर कम्युनिटी के अंदर हैं, लेकिन इनको इनको ये पता ही नहीं है। तो वो सोचते हैं हम कैसे गवर्नमेंट जॉब अप्लाई करें, किस उसमें करें, वो खुद बहुत परेशानी में है।
एक वन आई जस्ट वांट टू अंडरस्टैंड कि जो रिहैबिलिटेशन सेंटर है, डोंट यू थिंक कि समवेयर डाउन द लाइन समबडी हु इज वेरी लिटिल प्रिविलेज्ड कहीं ना कहीं उस रिहैबिलिटेशन सेंटर का उसे फ़ायदा मिल सकता है?
सी, provide for a rehab, open rehabilitation centers in each state, but don't put it in a legislation, don't make it mandatory. If a trans child has nowhere to go, have a rehabilitation center in the state, they'll at least use some transportation facility and reach the rehabilitation center or contact someone from the government, but don't make it mandatory and don't put it in a bill. You can put it in a bill in such a way that you should mandate every state to reopen rehabilitation centers. You should mandate all states to open rehabilitation centers. You should not mandate, put the mandate on us to go into that place and nowhere. The bill does not mention, if you were even in the previous questions you were asking, so there is no time limit to give a certificate. So it's like a pocket veto of precedent. The district magistrate can go on forever. Why he will not give a, there is no particular time limit, there is no confidentiality clause. What this is, the identifying as a transgender person or a man or a woman, having a gender change in your legal documents is an extremely humiliating process in our society. People humiliate us like anything. So confidentiality should be maintained. Where is provisions for that? And rehabilitation centers may be, where have they opened rehabilitation centers anywhere in this country? There is no housing rights pehle. If there are enough housing rights, we would not even need rehabilitation centers. There will be houses that will be open for us where we'll go and stay.
And also, if a person goes to rehabilitation center, then what will happen? At least you give free surgery. If a trans person goes to a rehab center and he says that I want to be a male and I need surgery, are you giving him free surgeries? You are simply saying go and get your surgery done and get the certificate. And we will tell that if surgery is okay or not. So doctor is also not responsible. You will judge on your own that the surgery is good or not, like you are male or not, and then you will provide the certificate. So they are not facilities.
Has the community met the social justice empowerment minister and spoken with him?
The community has met the social justice minister many times, and there was a parliamentary standing committee before which there were many transgender persons who came and deposed and said what is the problems. This bill was sent to a parliamentary standing committee of both Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha MPs. None of the recommendations of the parliamentary standing committee made to the bill. Nothing. They may have improved the definition, but none of the important recommendations which ensure our rights reached. So it's not like Thavarchand Gehlot is is unaware of our concerns. He's completely aware of our concerns.
And none of the nobody from the community was also spoken to for this.
No, when the bill came, nobody knew that when the bill is going to come. Nobody knew what was in the bill. The bill,
it was kept as secret. It was just a shock for the community.
When it was introduced in Lok Sabha, we didn't even know that the bill was going to come. We didn't know what are the contents of the bill. When you have a bill, you should open it up to public consultation for 30 days, 40 days, say around at least 2-3 months, because this requires translation to reach it to the last person on the streets. That was not done. The bill in its Hindi version still has Ubhayalingi Vyakti. Ubhayalingi is not a correct word for transgender persons, because transgender person word is an umbrella term. Such small things on which a lot of people gave inputs was not even taken.
Thank you both of you for joining us in this discussion. The bill that was passed yesterday does not have a clear definition of what discrimination is. It does not even have the provisions for reservation that the community demanded. But here's it is. So the bill is passed, and we have a new Transgender Persons Protection Rights Bill 2019. Thank you for watching.
To receive instant updates on all videos from The Wire, click the subscribe button and hit the bell icon. Pay to support independent journalism. Click the link in the description and choose the amount you want to pay.